Today, no Dhamma Pada talk. So I'm going to teach you something. I think last Sunday or two Sundays, you have learned to recite some extra verses, isn't it? Can you recite now? You still cannot. You can see the wording there? The word, how to recite. Although you can recite, still you do not know the significance of these recitals. That's what I wanted to tell you. Now, first you follow me. Not word by word. Not together. Follow me for you to pick up the correct pronunciation. Look at. Arahaṁ arhoti nāmena.
Then
we also came to know that he has no secrets in his life. All the others in this world have some sort of secret. But he has no secret. He has no hypocrisy. He has no selfishness. So we appreciate this attitude. That means this sacredness. Therefore, we bow down, pay respect. He also attained the fruits of arahantship. That means that is the highest achievement in our life. We can gain anything here in this world, still we are not perfect, subject to make mistakes and maintain some wrong concept and wrong idea. But one day, when we attain that highest stage of sainthood or arahanthood, we will be free from all our worldly worries and suffering. Our minds will be free. There won't be any more worries and disturbances. So Buddha is one of them. And now there is another, a little bit of controversy here. What is the difference between the Buddha and Arahant? This word Arahant we can use for the Buddha also. That is one of the characteristics. But there are Arahantas who attain the holy sainthood. But they possess only that particular quality. The Buddha had so many others, so Arahanthood or Arahantship or the quality is one of them. Now it is clear. I have no time to explain in detail. There will be another talk here. Now number two. First, follow me. Sammā sambuddha jñānena.
Sammā
sambuddha desanā. Enlightened one is he in the world. To thee, the fully enlightened one, my homage be. So in simple language, I pay my respect to an enlightened religious teacher. Now that is the real meaning. Now, only one word here. This is the most important word among all the other virtues. Sammā sambuddha. And the difference here, Buddha and Sammā sambuddha. there are some other Buddhas, like Paccheka Buddhas, but they are not Samma Sambuddha. Samma Sambuddha means supreme enlightened, the highest and greatest supreme enlightenment, Samma Sambuddha. Then what is this enlightenment? So in simple language, you can understand. Try. Now we cannot understand things properly. Yes, we know that. Why we cannot understand things properly? Our minds are deluded, clouded, polluted, and we maintain so many imaginations. Because of that, we cannot understand things properly. To gain his enlightenment, the Buddha had to work. Earlier, he had to work very hard to get rid of those mental defilements, mental impurities, and mental disturbances to maintain purity in the mind. So he went on developing, cultivating his mind. He went on training his mind. Then he went on purifying his mind. When all these things are completed, he gained enlightenment. That means can understand everything that which exists in this universe. So we pay respect to that religious teacher. Now next one. Number three. Vijja charana sampanno. Vijjāpakāsitā atītā nāgatuppannā vijjācarana te namo. Vijjācarana sampanno tassa vijjāpakāsitā atītā nāgatuppannā vijjācarana te namo. Meaning. Can you switch on this fan also? Setting very hot, slow. Meaning, he is endowed with wisdom and knowledge. His wisdom is made known. The past and the future he knows. To thee who is endowed with wisdom and knowledge, my homage be. So there are two words here. Vijja Charana Sampanna. One who maintain Vijja and Charana. These two qualities. This is also very important. Knowledge and wisdom and conduct. Knowledge and wisdom we can take as one item, and conduct is the most important thing. Conduct means all the great good qualities and virtues and wisdom. There are many religious people, learned people, philosophers, in this world. They have wonderful knowledge and wisdom, but their conduct, their character, their behavior, temperament, attitude, moods are not so advanced. Advanced means mind is polluted with either egoism, jealousy, anger, greed, selfishness. Knowledge is wonderful. So, in the case of the Buddha, he got his knowledge and wisdom, and he also maintained all the good qualities as most compassionate, enlightened religious teacher. Now these two things combine together, wisdom and conduct. Now that is the meaning of this word. Number four. Sugato sugatattanam. Sugato sundaram piche. Nibbanam sugatin yanti. Sugato namate namo. Sugato sugatattanam, sugato sundaram piche, nibbanam sugatin yanti, sugato namate namo. Meaning, he is Sugata, being self-disciplined, being good, he is Sugata. He has gone to the good states of Nibbana. To thee, the Sugata, my homage be. With another word, Sugata. The real meaning of this word is who has gone away from this world after fulfilling all his duties, after fulfilling his mission, after rendering a wonderful service to mankind. That is the meaning of this word. Easy for you to remember. So many others, millions and millions of others also depart from this world, but they have not completed their duties. They have not done any service to others. They were so selfish. They were narrow-minded. But in the case of the Buddha, he has dedicated his whole life, disregarding his own pleasure, his own happiness, and prolonging his own salvation because of the suffering mankind. So he appeared as a Buddha to serve the mankind, not only to mankind. Every living being, he is the religious teacher who advised us not to disturb, not to destroy, not to kill even other living beings also. So other living beings also got freedom because of him. He also mentioned about the devas and so many other different kinds of living beings in this universe and advised us to radiate our loving kindness towards them. So he has not neglected any living being that which exists in this universe, that was his mission. So we pay respect to such holy man who has rendered a wonderful service to mankind. Number 5. Loka viduti namena. Atitanagate vidu. Sankara satta mukhase. Te namo in the case of the Buddha, he had that penetrating knowledge to go through all the existing world system, world cycle, universes, then explained the nature of this world system, the nature of living being exists in different parts of the world system. So in his teaching, he mentioned the whole universe, he categorized into 31 groups, just like animals, humans, and spirit, and ghosts, and devas, and brahmas, and visible, and invisible, into 31 groups in the whole universe. So others could not give such clear exposition or interpretation of the world system. He also mentioned there are some living beings with a physical body, visible. Some other living beings are so radiant and beautiful, very luminous, and some other living being invisible, but the life exists. So again he divided the whole universe into 3 groups. Ordinary living being, just like human beings and animals, one group. Another group like devas and certain brahmas, so radiant and luminous. Another group as certain brahmas invisible. 3 group. That is why he is known as Loka Vidu, one who knows the nature of the world. Another meaning. to many others, this world was created by someone. That is their belief. The Buddha says, there is nobody to create this world. When conditions arise, these conditions combine together, different formations take place. And these elements and materials and energies exist for a long period. Then again going on dissolving. So one day dissolution take place, disintegration take place, and forever this situation exists, appear, exist, disappear, appear, exist, disappear. And this is the nature of the whole universe. It is not an act of Buddha or God or anybody. In that sense, he is known as Lokavidu, knower of the world. Number 6. Anuttaro jnana silena. Other part of the world whom we can compare with the Buddha. That's all. So simple. I told you there may be or there were or there will be so many learned people, holy people, intelligent people, great people in this world. But we cannot compare any of them with the Buddha. They have one or two qualities of the Buddha in them. So we do not condemn them. We also can respect them. We can respect other religious teachers also. They too have some good qualities and virtues. But definitely they are not the Buddhas. That is the meaning. We cannot accommodate them as the Buddha. We can respect them as religious teachers, as learned people, or who have rendered wonderful service to mankind. But the enlightenment and the real wisdom we cannot find in them. In that sense, he is known as Anuttara, incomparable.
Next one.
Compare.
Number 7.
Sarathi, Sarathi Deva. पूज लोकास्मिन् तं नमस्सामि सारथि 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 देवा यो लोकस्य सारथि सारथि पूज लोकास्मिन् तं नमस्सामि सारथि मीनिंग a charioteer is he of devas. He is a charioteer to the world. He is a respectful charioteer in this world. That charioteer I salute. Sarathi, charioteer, English word, that means one who carries others. A driver can become a sarathi. A driver of a lorry or a motor car or train who carries so many others. In that sense, he carries us. So he has paved the way for us to show the path, which direction that we should tread. So in that sense, he is a teacher, he is a master, not only to the human being. That is why I say, Sarathi Deva, to the devas, devas, brahmas, human beings and other living beings also. He is a teacher to all of them. Next one, number 8. Deva yakka manussanam. Loke agga phalam dadam. Dadantam damayantanam. Purisajanyate namo Devayakmanusanam Loke agphalam dadam Dadantam damayantanam Purisa janyate namo. To devas, yakkas and men in this world, he gives the highest fruits. The givers he subdues to the number of men, my homage be. To devas, yakkas and men, here three group. He gives the highest fruits. What sort of fruits? Apple? Fruits means a good result, good effects, fruits. Then the givers he subdues to the knower of men, my homage be. So one word is here, Devayakka manussanam lokeyagga palang dadam dadantam damayantanu purisa janya. Purisa ajanya. One who provides good result or good effect good experience to human beings, devas, and yakkas. Who are these people, yakkas? Where do they live? Do you know the meaning of yakkas? Supposed to be very powerful and very cruel, very dangerous people. Yakka. English word is devil, demon, ghost. There are some stories I think you have heard. Unfortunately, I have no time to explain how the Buddha approached them and how he tamed them. And after that, how they followed him and become his followers. That is the way how he trained and tamed even those yakkas, cannibals who lived on animal flesh, and evildoers. So he can train, he can teach, he can guide, he can show the good result to human beings, devas, brahmas, and yakkas. To such holy religious teacher, I pay homage. Next one, last one. Bhagava Bhagava Yutto. Than ours. Then why do we introduce him as the most fortunate one? Because he has no worries in his mind. How fortunate. We have so many worries, isn't it? He has no responsibilities in his mind. He has no worldly bondages. He has no mental disturbances. He has no greed, selfishness, anger, jealousy. Mind is pure. So he is free from all the other problems that we are suffering from. So in that sense, he is the most fortunate one. Not by considering the worldly thing. So here the meaning is given, the Bhagava is replete with fortune. So reached the higher stage, completed, no more for him to gain experience, complete bliss, satisfaction in his life. He has destroyed all the passion. Passion means passion, mental defilement. We have a lot of mental impurities known as passions. He has no such thing to disturb the mind. He has crossed the ocean of samsara. That means repeated birth and death is called oceans of samsara. We are running. Now we are here today, within this lifetime. After our death, we do not know. Today we cannot say what will happen to us, what would be the fate or the destiny. And another existence take place. After spending there for some time, again die. Another existence take place. Every time, in every existence, we accumulate so much of good and bad, both good karma and bad karma. So rebirth, existence, or pleasant, unpleasant, fortunate or unfortunate, all these occurrences take place according to our way of life, not according to will of Buddha or God. We are responsible. Individually, we are responsible for our life. That is why we have to learn how to lead a respectable, noble life. And then, one day, we also get the chance to get rid of this repeated birth and death. Because forever, we have to cry, we have to worry, because of birth and sickness and old age and death and pain. Every day we cry, we worry. After that, we will be free from all these things that we suffer today. So the Buddha is free from all these things. Therefore, he is called Bhagava, fortunate one. Now, you can understand what you recite. As Ittipiso, Bhagava, Arahang, Samma Sambuddho, Vijjacharana Sampanno, Sugato, Lokavidu, Anuttaro, Purisa Dhamma Sarati, Satta, Deva Manussanam, Buddho Bhagava. Now you have confidence. You know what you decide. So, very long service today. Okay, the blessing, not yet, huh? Okay.